You know about fasting blood glucose, you know about your A1C, but did you know that there are additional tests that can give you an insight about how are you doing as a diabetic? That's exactly what we're going to discuss in this video. We're going to discuss one test that's like the stress test as a diabetic. There's a stress test for the heart, there's also a stress test for diabetes. Going to talk about one other test that will give you an early warning sign about how are you likely to become a diabetic over the next 1 to 3 years, and one other test that you can look forward to discussing. Before we jump in, who am I? My name is Igor. I'm the author of the Amazon best-selling book called Type 2 Diabetes Reversal Secrets. As well, I run an online personal training company called Fitness Solutions Plus that specializes in helping type 2 diabetics reverse their diabetes. So let's jump in. First, let's discuss the two tests you already know about for sure. One is fasting blood glucose. What is that? Your fasting blood glucose is a snapshot in time. It's what your blood sugar is at the moment that the blood was drawn. Could have been lower or higher an hour ago, could have been lower or higher an hour from now. So it's a useful measurement, but it's not a complete measurement. So to get around the drawbacks of fasting blood glucose, the test of HbA1c, or also called glycated hemoglobin, that's why that was invented. Because what that test does is it gives you your average blood sugar over the last 3 months. It ignores any fluctuations and it gives you one specific number. Typically, if it's over 6.5%, you're considered a diabetic. If it's between 6.0 and 6.4%, you're considered a pre-diabetic. So that's the benefit of HbA1c, but there are also drawbacks. Maybe it gives you a good blood sugar level while ignoring fluctuations. Maybe your blood sugar dips so low and then goes so high after meals that the average is good. But what you don't see is what's called glycemic variability, the difference between your highs and lows. To give you some numbers specifically, a good fasting blood sugar might be somewhere between 4.5 and 5.5. But what if your fasting blood sugar goes below 4.5 and then your blood sugar after a meal goes way too high? Well, then your HbA1c says it's normal, but the variability is too wide. So those are the problems with A1c. Some ways to get around to show you what A1c is not showing you is a test called Glycomark. Glycomark is a test of what's called glycemic variability. That is the difference between your highest blood sugar levels and your lowest blood sugar levels. It's actually more damaging to your body to have wide ranges from low to high than a constantly high blood sugar level. So insulin resistance is actually better than high glycemic variability to some extent. So that is one test. Again, that's called Glycomark. Test number two is what we call the stress test for your blood sugar levels, and that's called the OGTT. That is the oral glucose tolerance test. The way this test works is they give you a solution of 75 grams of glucose to ingest, and they measure your blood sugar before you take that in, and then at 20 to 30 minute intervals for anywhere from 2 to 6 hours afterwards. What should happen is within 20, 30 minutes, your blood sugar should start to rise. It should peak around an hour or so after your ingestion, and then it should decline and then get back to normal about 2 hours or so after you ingest it. The problem with diabetics is that, especially if you're insulin resistant, is that it spikes and then it stays high and takes longer than 2 hours to come back, and the spike is too high. Generally speaking, you don't want the spike to be above 7.2 millimoles per liter. Now, in the cases of diabetics, that spikes a lot higher than 7.2, and again, takes longer than 2 hours to come back to normal. Normal should be somewhere between 4.5 and 5.5. That is fasting levels. So that is the stress test for your blood sugar. Again, that's called the OGTT, or the oral glucose tolerance test. And the final test that I'll discuss is called C-peptide. C-peptide is a measurement of your fasting insulin. So if you're wondering, why not just measure fasting insulin? It's because fasting insulin is pretty unstable. But C-peptide is a protein released by the pancreas at the same time as insulin. For every molecule of insulin released, the pancreas also releases a molecule of C-peptide. But unlike fasting insulin, which is very unstable in the blood, C-peptide has great stability. So you actually get better insights into your insulin by measuring C-peptide than by measuring insulin. And so what that tells you about is something called insulin sensitivity. Let's say two people have perfect blood sugar levels. But what brings blood sugar levels down? It's the hormone insulin. Maybe one person requires 10 units of insulin to bring it down, another person requires 20 units of insulin to bring it down. Both cases have the same blood sugar levels, but the one that needs more insulin to bring it down is the more insulin-resistant person, or the less healthy person. The one that requires less insulin to bring it down is the healthier person, or the more insulin-sensitive person. And so that's why this is a very useful test for diabetics, and this can detect your diabetes years before you actually become a diabetic. And again, that is called C-peptide. Now, what do you do with the information from all of these tests? Let's say your blood sugar control is not great. What can you do about it? Well, in many of my other videos, I discuss exercise, how do you exercise the right way for type 2 diabetes that can lower your A1C by between 1.2 and 1.5%. You can also use nutrition. What are the three most important nutritional factors for type 2 diabetics, which again, I also discuss in other videos linked in the description below. And I have a video on the four most powerful supplements to help you lower your A1C by 1.0% or more, also linked in the description below. If you like this video, please click like and subscribe, and that will help you be notified when I publish more videos just like this, and it will help other type 2 diabetics get great information about their diabetes. Thank you and goodbye.